we must strengthen democracy. This is a critical moment. Authoritarianism is on the rise around the world. Technology is being used to silence dissent and prosecute citizens. And democracies must answer the call to fight back against disinformation, stand up for internet freedom, reduce the misuse of surveillance technology, establish standards of responsible conduct in cyberspace. Meanwhile, governments are becoming less transparent. Corruption is growing. In many places, elections are flashpoints for violence. And the pandemic has accelerated many of these trends. We see this happening across Africa. Leaders ignoring term limits, rigging or postponing elections, exploiting social grievances to gain and maintain power, arresting opposition figures, cracking down on the media, and allowing security services to enforce pandemic restrictions with brutality. Many Africans are now living under at least partially authoritarian governments. And militaries have taken over civilian governments 4 times this year. That's the highest number in 4 decades. There are good news stories about democracy in Africa, too. In Niger, which had its first ever peaceful transfer of power this year, or Zambia, where the opposition party won elections, something few believed would be allowed to happen. Citizens there woke up long before dawn, some sleeping all night at polling stations, to make sure that they could vote. And even in places where democracy is under duress, it's inspiring to see people courageously raising their voices and calling for change, like the citizens marching in the streets and cities across Sudan to restore the civilian-led transition. Still, the recession of democracy in many places in Africa cannot be denied. And it is not the will of the people. Survey after survey in countries across the continent show that the people of Africa, be they Ghanaian or Zambian or Ugandan or Tanzanian, support democracy. When given the choice between multi-party elections or strongman rule, one-party states or military control, they choose multi-party elections. That makes it all the more important that leaders show leadership and stop the democratic backsliding that is wiping away their citizens' aspirations. Now, I want to emphasize that democratic backsliding is not just an African problem. It's a global problem. My own country is struggling with threats to our democracy. And the solutions to those threats will come as much from Africa as from anywhere. We need countries from every part of the world to share best practices, to make public pledges, to hold each other accountable. And we need to show how democracies can deliver what citizens want quickly and effectively. When we fail to do that, people lose their trust in the democratic model. And that fuels the arguments that authoritarian governments make, that their system is better. Americans and Africans share a yearning to live in places where their rights are respected, their voices are heard, their governments answer to them and deliver for them. Working together, we can support democracy in our countries and around the world.